Recent devastation in the Carolinas from Hurricane Florence, and the majority of the damage and loss of life is due to flooding. So what about flood insurance, you ask? Well, real estate expert John Adams is here to help sort out the facts. And there is some confusion when it comes to flood insurance.
There really is, Buck. So many people start with the assumption, I've got insurance.
Right.
And everything's covered. Well, unfortunately, that's not the case.
You got five facts for us, don't
you? Real quick, let's point out five quick facts. Number one. 1 inch of water, Buck, can cause $25,000 worth of damage. It's just, it's devastating to our structures. Number two, homeowners and renters insurance, as I say, typically does not cover damage from flooding, but 43% of people think it does. Number three, more than 20% of flood claims come from outside high-risk flood zones, so these people weren't expecting it. Number four, flood insurance can pay regardless of whether or not there's a presidential declaration or a disaster. We call that a disaster declaration. And then number five, disaster assistance usually does come in two forms. SBA loans, which have to be paid back, albeit at a low rate of interest. And then they have FEMA, in some cases, FEMA disaster grants, which are usually about $5,000. That's in the face of a typical claim, about $30,000.
Of course, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about who needs flood insurance and who doesn't.
Well, it's based on the likelihood that your property is going to experience flooding. And this is all based on historical averages over the last 100 years when they've been keeping these records. So we hear about a 100-year floodplain. What's the likelihood of this area flooding? They're constantly changing these maps, and whether your home is or is not in a flood area is very important. So you need to keep up with that, and it's all on the internet. You can go to FEMA and look at these maps.
So the question, am I required to have flood insurance? And the answer is it depends.
Well, it does depend. If you are in a FEMA flood zone, a high-risk zone, and you have a federally insured mortgage, the answer is yes. Otherwise, it's entirely up to you.
We're running out of time here, so if you can just go ahead and cut to the bottom line, what people need to know when it comes to flood insurance.
The real key here to remember is that flood insurance is not the same as your homeowner's insurance. And if you live in a high-risk area, you need to get this coverage because, as we've seen from the recent hurricane, the devastation in the Carolinas simply shocking, and most of those people are not covered.
And even if you don't live in a high-risk area, it can still happen to you, right?
If you live on top of Stone Mountain, you're safe. Otherwise, we are all at some level of risk.
They're not selling real estate up there on top of Stone Mountain.
No, not for sale.
Yeah, not for sale. All right, John, good advice as always. Thanks a lot. All right, the Falcons are figuring out what to do after Ricardo Allen's season-ending injury.